Hey guys, got another holster to share with you. This is again from G-Code. They're getting to be one of my favorite holster companies. They're located out of Jacksonville, North Carolina, and they're manufactured by a company called Edgeworks. They do have a website. It's range5.com. And this particular holster model is called the SOC or SOC RIG. And very cool looking holster. This is somewhat of a hybrid holster, I would say it is, because the top portion is made of a glass-filled polymer, while the rear portion, or the rear cowling, is of Kydex. You also have an adjustment screw here for the tension. Now, the one very cool thing about this type of holster, or this holster, is that if you have a weapon light, you can order a different cowling that accepts that particular light. Now, I checked out their website, and they do have different lower cowlings for several different manufacturers of weapon lights. So, you know, you got to go there to range5.com and check out, you know, what's available. But this has a dual retention system, one being the lower portion, the Kydex part, this adjustment screw here, this tension screw, and also it's got a strap here, or a retention bar, similar a release mechanism as the XST. It's a thumb release, and it flips open the retention bar very quickly. Okay, and this is the RTI model. This is the RTI hardware here, which allows it to be compatible with the RTI wheel that I have on my belt, and I'll show you how that works. This is slightly different than the XST, where this has full protection in the front. Let me put the gun in there. This is this one is particularly made for my Glock 17, and safety check in here. There's nothing down the barrel, no magazine. And you'll hear a very positive click once it goes in. Okay, very, very nice feeling click. Okay, and again, the whole front end of the barrel is protected. No problems with the excess big dot sights clearing the holster itself. Okay, as you can see, the retention bar there. How that looks. Very cool looking design. I really like this design here. Now, this one is slightly different, again, compared to the XST holster that I previously did a video on. This one has almost like a nub there that goes into the inside of the barrel. And again, full length sight rail, top sight rail there. So you should have no problems with any aftermarket sights. Okay. Again, the gun fits very nicely. Positive lock. When you engage the retention strap there, it's not going to come out of there at all. Okay, until you release that retention bar. And I think it looks like a very, very sharp looking holster. One very nice holster. I do plan on ordering the lower cowling once I get my light in. Just depends on, I'm doing some research on what type of light for this pistol. And after I get the light, I'll go ahead and order the lower cowling with the light, and I'll go ahead and do a video on that. But looks like it's very easily changed with these screws here from the top. You can easily change that. Okay. And again, this is the RTI model, so it has the hardware to be compatible with the RTI wheel, and I'll go ahead and show you how that fits on the on my belt. Alright guys, this is the RTI wheel. This is intended for being mounted to a MOLLE system, but as you can see, I have it on a 1 3/4 inch web belt. and it works just fine. It holds it, it's not going to shift or go anywhere. And the hardware, these three little nubs here, correspond to the holes on the RTI wheel, and they just snap right in and lock down, and it's not going anywhere. So very solid mount for this. Now take a closer look at the RTI wheel itself, because it's a very pretty ingenious system. Again, the hardware that's on the back of these holsters, this is the SOC holster, and this is the XST holster, and both are compatible since it's got this hardware. They do have corresponding holes where these fit into and slide in, okay, and basically put it in and it slides down and you lock it in place, and it's a very solid mount. But basically the RTI wheel, once you get the holster mounted, slid into these little slots here, just push this button over and it really locks it into place. To unlock it, basically just squeeze these two tabs or push one in. I think you gotta, yeah, both of them in. Kind of push, squeeze both of these tabs together and it automatically unlocks. So this system is a very, very nice system, because if you have, say, one holster for your Beretta and one holster for your Glock, you know, one day you could be wearing this, okay, for your Beretta. The next day you want to, or in the next hour, the next minute, you want to change over to your Glock. You already have your Glock in your holster. Just slide that in and you're finished. It's really convenient. It's really convenient if you're thinking about having a gun inside of your vehicle. And the majority of us probably place it in the center console. And that's, you know, kind of dangerous once you think about it. It could be sloshing around. You know, when you're putting on your brakes, when you're accelerating, that gun is always constantly moving. And that gives it opportunity for an accidental discharge. Now, most likely that gun is pointed, you know, towards the front of the cab. Unfortunately, there's smaller guns there, you know, that could be sloshed around, and you have the potential for that gun to be pointed towards your passenger or yourself. So with this system here, I plan on getting just the wheel itself and then using these holes to mount it in inside my center console face down. I have a pretty large center console, and this will work just perfect. I did do a test run to see if this holster fits inside at a certain angle where it's easily accessible. Okay, now that once I have that mounted inside the center console, it's all a matter of being able to put this in, lock it down securely, and that gun's not going to go anywhere. Whoops, I never did lock it down. And basically that gun is not going to go anywhere. It's going to be pointed in a safe direction. Even when I accelerate or under hard braking, it's not going to shift around. Okay, that's one thing to think about. And when I get to the range, take it out of the wheel out of the truck, put my belt on, put my holster on, and I'm ready to go. So that's makes it really convenient with this system here. But back to the SOC rig. It's a very well-made holster. I think this is all glass reinforced polymer. Very, very tough looking material. Kydex, you know, what can I say about Kydex? I mean, they're one of the most popular holster materials right now. Again, I forgot to mention in my XST holster that you do have a rough texture on the outer surface, but on the inside of the holster, it's a very smooth surface. Okay, that's really important, because it aids in being able to draw that weapon out smoothly and quickly. Okay, with nothing, no more tension than you would need, besides what you use to adjust the tension on the lower portion of the holster. So the inside of the holster being smooth is very important. And again, you could see here, it's all smoothed out. All the edges are rolled over very nicely. no sharp edges anywhere. Again, to compare it with the XST, very smooth inside the holster itself. All the hardware that is holding this retention system together, as you can see, is recessed, so it's not going to damage your gun. Okay, they're all recessed inside there. Nothing's going to touch your pistol and mar it up. Okay, so that's one thing I didn't point out the last time. Again, with this, all the major hardware is not going to touch your pistol here. Let's see if I can get some light down there. Okay, everything is recessed, so your gun is not going to get scratched at all. Okay. So that's the SOC holster. I'll show you again with the gun in it. Very nice click to it. Very very nice looking holster. I really like the design of it. This sits similar to the XST holster. If you don't know, how this will sit on a belt, I have a video of the XST holster and how it sits. And this sits just about the same. It does sit outwards slightly on the body, but that allows you to have body armor and still have access to the release mechanism here. So that's really, really something to think about. I know that for a while I was using the Safari Land, and I could see the potential that if you are wearing some body armor, that release mechanism on the Safari Land was very difficult and sometimes very sloppy to get to before you were able to actually release it. This sits far enough away where you do still have clearance and be able to access that release mechanism very easily. So, really happy with this holster. I invite you to go check them out at range5.com. And again, this is the G-Code SOC holster. Great company. They're it's just unbelievable that they're pricing these things the way they are, because it's well worth the money. And hopefully I want to get the word out on these holsters, because it's a great value compared to just about anything else out there. Now I know that Blackhawk, Safari Land, they do have some very cool items, very similar items to these G-codes, but I find it that these are much more competitively priced, and you're getting the same value, maybe even better value. I know the quality of these are excellent in comparison to say a Safari Land, which those run quite a bit of money. And these holsters here from G-Code are well worth it. Very nicely made. Tell me what you guys think about it, and thanks for watching.